Welcome back. 6:53, time for the morning sprint. The situation at the U.S.-Mexico border, the topic of a roundtable discussion in Wisconsin with Senator Ron Johnson in Milwaukee. Johnson, who is a member of the Homeland Security Committee, said he wanted to hear about what he calls the failures of the Biden administration. Johnson, who is up for re-election this year, invited border security leaders, immigration experts, and the parent of a teen who died of a fentanyl overdose. In West Allis, the Wisconsin State Fair says more than 1 million people attended the 11-day event this year. Get this, that's a 20% increase from last year. The fair says the Wisconsin Bakers Association served 320,000 cream puffs and more than 100,000 ears of corn to fairgoers. That right there is Florence Edwards Miller getting her baby girl Sylvia vaccinated against COVID at the Children's Museum here in Madison. They're hosting a vaccine clinic for area parents to make the experience less scary for kids. Sylvia got a severe case of COVID about a month ago. She had to be put on steroids to help with symptoms. Now that she's 6 months old, Florence wanted to make sure to protect her daughter as best she could. You can find an appointment to get a kid's vaccine at the museum yourself. More information on channel3000.com. Decatur Dairy in Broadhead breaking ground this week on a new multi-million dollar facility. The 23,000 square foot building will cost about $6 million to build. The expansion was made possible in part by a recent grant from the Wisconsin Department of Agriculture. The plant produces cheese with milk for more than 70 cooperative members across South Central Wisconsin, bringing much needed business to local farmers. And the most visited national park adding some new parking fees next time you head over. Starting March 1st, vehicles parked at the Great Smoky Mountains National Park for longer than 15 minutes, gonna need a tag. It'll cost you $5 for a day pass or $15 for a 7-day pass. The new program is called Park It Forward. The money raised here will help cover park costs.
And we're looking at actually cooler conditions. We actually get some 40s now this morning as we get into the middle of the end of August here. So overall sky conditions are good. We still have some fog out there, but it is now back up to 54. It was 53 last hour, so we're actually improving. Overall, 80 degrees is what we expect for most of the area today. And then we look at precip chances. Once again, Saturday is the day to look for and Sunday, but overall that looks to be a wet and cool weekend to be on tap. So traffic-wise, no issues going on right now. Speak of weather-wise, traffic-wise, other than your morning commute. But so it's going to be a cool condition today and good travel, but warmer tomorrow.
All right, Greg, thanks so much. Thanks for joining us this morning, folks. We'll be right back.